Hello! Today we're going to talk about balanced signals. This is mostly a thing for audio, but we use them in lighting as well for control signals like DMX. Now, if you want to send information using electricity, the most basic way of doing it is to vary the voltage over time. Measuring voltage is like measuring distance. You need two points to measure between. It's why your meter has two probes on it. You use one of them to define something as 0 volts, and then you measure the voltage, the electrical pressure, between the two probes. The very earliest forms of wired electrical signal transmission were telegraphs. You had a single signal wire, and the other ends of your circuits were literally plugged straight into the ground, using that as 0 volts. You would then use a battery and some other stuff to either raise or not raise the voltage on the line. It worked, but it wasn't great. It could not convey subtleties. It was either on or off. When transmitting information between modern pieces of equipment, you usually have a second wire that's connected between the chassis of the two pieces of equipment and possibly also directly to ground that provides a more consistent 0 voltage, so you can more easily send intelligible information, like audio, instead of just tone and no tone. The return path for electrical current, the reference against which you measure your voltage, is known as ground, or earth if you're British, and is called that due to the original telegraph wiring and the fact that even in modern buildings, the ground is connected to quite literally a long copper rod hammered into the dirt. It can also be the frame of a piece of equipment, the chassis of an automobile, although if it's not connected to dirt, it is technically a commons instead of a ground. If you're using a pair of wires to carry a signal, you normally have one signal wire and one common wire. You then measure the voltage between them, and by varying that voltage over time, you transmit information. Now, this generally works fine. It's what most home audio equipment uses. But there is one problem with it. The universe is full of magnetic fields and electromagnetic waves that just love inducing voltages in wires, including the one you're using to carry your signal. Now, if you're just measuring against ground, then those little fluctuations can raise or lower the voltage in your signal wire and mess with your signal. The Earth is indifferent to these transient voltages and remains at zero, resulting in this, which doesn't sound great. The first people to have to seriously deal with this problem were the ones that were running early telephone networks, having to string wires for miles between towns and get them to carry intelligible audio. And as far as I can tell, Alexander Graham Bell came up with the idea of the balanced circuit. He did actually use a device based on a balanced circuit to try and detect the bullet in President James Garfield after he had been shot. It didn't work, but since it didn't make the injury worse, he actually was more effective than any of the doctors present at the time. In a balanced circuit, we use two signal wires. That have identical impedance, which means they react to changes in voltage the same way, and we compare them to each other instead of comparing to ground. Any interference should affect them both equally and thus be canceled out when we compare them to each other. It's very clever and it is very good at rejecting interference, which is important when you have a mic line or a DMX cable running across a stage covered in power cords. You could send the signal down one wire and just leave the other one alone to serve as a reference. That'd probably work. Here we have our signal in blue and our reference line in yellow. We will add noise in red, which then affects both wires identically. If we then measure between reference and signal, you can see that as the noise pushes the signal up or down, it pushes the reference up or down as well. So if we measure the distance between them, or the voltage between them, and then redraw those measurements lined up with our graph, we wind up with this. Our original signal. Now that would probably work. However, in audio and DMX, we use what are known as symmetric antiphase signals. which is just a fancy way of saying that the two signals are mirror images of each other, which means that if one of them is doing this, the other is doing this. An audio signal looks like this. So let's go back to our original signal here. We've got our two signals, which are opposites to each other. We will then add in some noise and apply it to both signals. But once again, you can see that as one signal gets raised by the noise, the other one does as well, so that the distance between them doesn't change. So if we go through our whole sample and measure that distance, and then take those measurements and line them up with the graph, we can see that once again, despite quite a lot of noise, we have our original signal. But why would you do this? Well, you need to prevent your signal from interfering with other signals, which is important if you've got a dozen mic lines crammed into a single multi-pair cable. As we mentioned earlier, a changing magnetic field can induce a voltage change in a wire. Also, a changing voltage in a wire can create a changing magnetic field, which can then induce a voltage in a different wire. This is why it's not a good idea to run your signal lines next to power cables. They're alternating current. As the power goes up and down and up and down, that is creating a constantly changing magnetic field, which is one of the ways you can get that lovely 60-cycle hum in your audio. So if you're sending two signals that are the opposites of each other, as one is going up, the other is going down, and they create opposing magnetic fields that cancel each other out. It's very neat. You'll also usually find that the two wires are twisted around each other, referred to as a twisted pair. This is because a balanced circuit rejects noise best when the two wires are equal distance from the noise. Unfortunately, you're never quite sure where that noise is coming from, especially on a crowded stage covered in cables. So by twisting the two wires around each other, you sort of average out the distance to the noise, no matter where it may be. And I know this one was Bell. I even found the patent. Now, using a balanced connection is more expensive, which is why most consumer stuff just has the two wires, your signal and your common, whereas most professional stuff has the three wires, signal plus, signal minus, and common. In the audio world, of course, there are exceptions to this. The most common is the humble headphone jack, which has three conductors, but is actually a pair of unbalanced signals. It is signal left, signal right, and a shared common. There are also exceptions to that exception that can mess with your sound in various entertaining ways, but we'll cover those in more detail when we start talking about sound. Anyway, that is all for now, and thank you for watching.
You know, bell balancing gongs. So, before he's a kid, to use the tape, when he was made from this measuring tape, I have this measuring tape and tape. To use this dimmer, there's a little bit of tape. So, I have a screwdriver.